Hi everyone, it's me. Welcome back. Today we are talking about cover letters because it is summer internship time and everyone's asking about cover letters. They don't know how to write their cover letters. They don't know what to do. So let me give you a few tips. So when you're writing a cover letter to someone, first of all, if you're gonna email it over, you always send it as an attachment. A lot of people ask about that. Do not put it in the body of your email. No one wants to open an email and see like multiple paragraphs, right? You want to open your inbox and you want to read something and it needs to be short, sweet, and to the point. So always attach your cover letter and you should always attach it as a PDF, okay? A PDF document. And this is going to ensure that no matter who opens it, what kind of computer they have, it always opens flawlessly. The cover letter should be about 3 to 4 paragraphs and it should only be one page. I don't care if it's that last paragraph that rolls on to the next page, a cover letter needs to be one page, okay? One page. And remember, we're keeping this short, sweet, and to the point. It's also really important to find the right tone in your cover letter. It's really tricky because you want to show a company that you're really passionate about working there, but you also don't want to come across as like a super stalker, crazy fangirl, right? And let's face it, some companies are our dream companies and we get really excited about them. So it's your job when you're writing this cover letter to come across as passionate yet professional. You are an expert in you, right? No one can speak to your capabilities better than you can. So make sure that your tone comes across. And if you have to rewrite this and reread this time after time, that's okay. A lot of people go through almost 5 revisions on their cover letter. The next thing is making sure the content is relevant and the cover letter doesn't come across as generic. If I'm an employer and I read your cover letter and I can tell very quickly that you've sent this cover letter to 20 other companies, I am not interested in you because you have not made me feel special. Your job is to make the employer feel special. So in the cover letter, you need to include relevant information that is specific to the position that you're applying for. The cover letter is your time to not only name drop big, cool companies you've worked for and things you've done, but also to expand upon them a little bit and really connect the dots for the employer. Why does what you did at your last internship really relate to the company that you're applying for? Why does that high school project you did in class really relate to the company that you're applying for? And remember, the cover letter should include the company name because you're showing the employer that you are customizing this document just for them. One other tip I want to share is that if you are a student and you go to Mizzou and you are applying to an internship in New York City, you have to state that you are going to be available and in New York City on that cover letter. If an employer looks at your resume, looks at your cover letter, it says Mizzou, and they're in New York City and you don't connect the dots for them and say, I'm going to be available to intern in New York City from May until August, or whatever the time frame is, the employer's gonna be confused. Why is this student applying for this position? And they're busy, they don't wanna take the time to figure it out. So again, connect the dots for the employer. Good luck, create those cover letters and get those applications out. This is the time.